The Ill-Gotten Party Assets Settlement Committee held a hearing today on whether to confiscate assets of Broadcasting Corporation of China, a private radio company established in 1928 by the KMT. Shareholders were irate as the committee made a case for confiscating company assets, which include 38 properties already sold. The chairman of the company defended himself against allegations of profiting off those sales. He pointed a finger at former President Lee Teng-hui, saying that Lee was in charge at the time the sales occurred.
We are investigating whether the KMT had control over the personnel, financial or business operations of the Broadcasting Corporation of China, and whether the KMT had sold off the company's assets at a reasonable price.
It was the second hearing on the financial past of Broadcasting Corporation of China. This time, the focus was on whether the government should nationalize the private company, along with 38 parcels of land that it had sold off.
I never touched that land. I have never touched that money. Why have they come after me? It's like what they say, where there is a debt, there is a lord. Li Denghui treats everyone to a meal, and then Chao Shao-kang has to foot the bill. Liu Tai-ying throws around money, and Chao Shao-kang is saddled with the aftercare. I have to clean up the mess. Is that reasonable?
Chao said that by the time he took over in 2006, the company was no longer KMT-owned. He said it had been a loss-making enterprise that he brought back to the black.
Since I came to Broadcasting Corporation of China, the KMT has not intervened. It has not participated. The stocks were bought off the listed market. You can't confiscate that on a whim. Think of how the shareholders would suffer.
The committee argued that in the 1950s, the KMT administration had appropriated Japanese assets for use by Broadcasting Corporation of China. The assets had been housing, not land. In acquiring ownership of the land, the company referred to itself as a party-owned state enterprise and illegally listed the land in its books, according to the committee.